oh my fucking god, so scuffed coming back home. I don't even remember how to stream. Hello everyone, and welcome to Norway. Do you miss Texas, or does it feel good to be back? I miss Texas, boys. I miss Texas a lot. I wish I could go back to Texas at once. Norwegian people, sorry. Americans, I hope you will welcome me. But I have this as a memory. We're already planned next America trip, just so you know, boys and girls. What do you think about this hat from... Listen, I wanted to talk about my trip home from the United States. Monday, post Camp Knut at 4 p.m. I was going directly into the car, Vujito. Directly after the gym, I was sitting with Vujito. I jumped in his car. He has a BMW M4, by the way. A really nice car. It was raining so much on the way down to the airport. But we had enough time to go there. We made it to the airport. It took me 2 minutes to go through. I miss America. I miss America. I'm just saying, you guys, I miss America. It's such a nice place. Texas, I love that place, guys. I'm just saying. I want to go back. We miss you too. Thank you, everyone, wherever you are from. I'm sorry if you take offense, but I love America. Even Norwegians, don't take offense. It's a great place. People talk a lot of shit about America, but it is a nice place. Welcome home, Knut. Thank you, Everett. Camp Knut Season 2 will come. We are going to have Camp Knut Season 2. Exactly time, exactly who, and exactly where, we don't know yet. It will be planned. It will probably be next year. I hope you all will remember how this year's event was and join in and watch next year like you did. Camp Knut 2023, that will be awesome. It is way too early. We have gotten requests. I have gotten requests from multiple people like, oh, maybe we can have a Camp Knut here. Maybe we can have a Camp Knut there. Do you know what I've said? No, you won't get any Camp Knut. Do you know why? Because I'm the leech. I'm picking Miskif. Maybe Hassan, he can join. Because he has a big following. I am the leech. Not you leeching from me because I had a good event. I am the leech here. I'm no Greek god leech that comes in taking $10,000 per hour to be on anyone's stream. I make a good event. I pull in some strings. I get some nice people in. And we make a fucking good show where I can leech. And they're all happy. But the thing is, we can't make Camp Knut Season 2. And it has no hype. There's no cool people that you want to see. There's just some people, some WH Omega lulz that you don't care about. We need to make a good Camp Knut Season 2. It has to be just as hyped as Season 1.
Cookies and cream.
I'm sure you all agree. Needs to be more hyped. Yes. The thing is, if I make Camp Knut Norway... Okay, maybe I shouldn't talk about other Norwegian streamers in a negative way, because there are a lot of amazing Norwegian streamers. The only problem is, they would speak in Norwegian. And I don't know any Norwegian streamer that would commit like the guys in Austin did and be there for 30 days. Just imagine Forsen. He's Swedish, but almost Norwegian. He lives close. Imagine if I invited Forsen. Do you think he would step out of his room? I'm sure you would have watched if Forsen joined, actually. No, we're waiting till next year. We're not overusing Camp Knut. We're not going to have any Camp Knut Norway. If someone wants to make a fitness event, we have now showed them it's possible to do it on Twitch. They can make their own. That is fine. Knut, have you given Lakari a workout plan after the camp? No, I haven't. I haven't been able to talk to anyone. As I said, we were after... Okay, now we can go back to the original story that I was talking about earlier. The trip home. 4 hours. When I got to the airport, I got the message. It was really fast. Check in luggage. Fast. Security check. I went to the security check. The guy said, are you going home, Knut? Yes, I'm going home from Texas. Yeah, I've been watching the camp. He said he had been watching the camp, the guy in the security check. So I went through and I looked, where the fuck is my flight on the list? It wasn't there. So I went, I looked at my ticket or my boarding pass. I saw which gate I was going to. I went up to the gate. There were some people standing. So I said, when is the, what is happening? It's 3 to 4 hours delayed. Because of fucking rain. 3 to 4 hours delayed. Lost to rain. Yes, exactly. The plane lost to rain. Okay, I'll have to wait. Ended up being 4 hours and 10 minutes or something. We boarded. Went pretty fast. Boarded. And we're in there. It was really, really fast after that. But I could already see at that point that I'm not going to catch my next flight. Bilik, thank you. And they said, a lot of you people here has connecting flights. They said over the speakers. We know we will come and talk to you individually and tell you what new flights you're getting. No one came to me. I didn't speak to anyone. So in London, I went off the plane. We took a bus from the plane into the airport. Right inside the door was a... some crew members from British Airways standing. The both of them, they're like, oh, connecting passengers, come here. I started to stand in line and they said, yeah, here you have your ticket. Tried to say my name in English. They said not. No, they didn't say not. I'm not sure what it I don't even remember, but they said it in a weird way. I got the ticket and she opened. It was like multiple papers. Yeah, you have a hotel on yours. And I'm like, fuck, I have to wait till your flight leaves tomorrow morning. Your flight leaves tomorrow morning.
The rain in Texas so was tired. All of us crying when you left.
Like, well, fuck, I'm so tired after this traveling. 4 hours late already. And now I have to wait one more day. That was annoying, I'll tell you. So I made a little IRL stream at the airport, I'll tell you. London Airport, Heathrow, it's fucking boring there. There's nothing to do at all. I even tried to walk a little bit around outside. It was nothing. UK Airport, and I'll tell you, there's some weird people over in the UK. You can kind of see that they're Brits. You can kind of see that they're Brits. Sorry. Not all of them. They were just standing there screaming different numbers. I don't know fucking know what that was. Good rants about England. There's one more scuffed thing I have to tell or talk about the UK. Listen. Even though you're not an EU member, Norway, we're not either. For the fucking love of God. The hell is this? I'm not wrong, and the same applies to the US here. You should use the same as we're doing, both UK and US. We can have the same standard, all of us. All of us.
Everything has to be measuring in stones.
I'm sure you agree, United States, people living there, we can have the same, all of us. Norway is better. Norwegian is better, yes. Why is that the best? It feels better to put it in. We're outside. Yeah, we will go outside soon. But I think we need to go through my Reddit. I have to show you this of Lakari. We come a long way. I won't argue that take. That's actually a feels too wrong man moment. We come a long way. What a transformation, yeah. Day one. Big luck. Yeah. He reminds me a bit about Bobby Lashley. I think Lakari will get there. Just a little bit more time. He could, yeah. This guy's 45, I know. Which one is Lakari? Hard to tell. He's a beast. Take him as your apprentice. I will take Lakari, yeah. He has the Ronnie genetics. Bobby, 6'3". They're all in WWE, let's be real. They're always lying. They're never In wrestling, they're always saying, "Fucking 6'9", 400 pounds." No, they're not. They're tall, yes, but they're adding in, but just height, both height and weight.